Okay, welcome back to my class. So today we'll discuss determination of poverty line and limitation of poverty line. So let us see this determination of poverty line. The official poverty line is determined by the Planning Commission, now Niti Aayog, on the basis of data provided by the National Sample Survey Office. So National Sample Survey Office used to collect the data related to the poverty in our country, and it is presented by the Niti Aayog, by the Planning Commission in our country. So there are various ways to measure the poverty line in our country, but in our country, let us see, we are using only two methods. So let us see what are that two methods. The first method used by the Niti Aayog or the Planning Commission is the minimum calorie intake method, and second one is known as monthly per capita expenditure. This is MPCE method. So let us see this minimum calorie intake. So Indian Council for Medical Research has recommended that each and every person living into the rural area should get minimum 2400 calories with the food intake, whereas the people living into the urban area should get minimum 2100 calories with the food intake. So let us see here, this the calories needed for the rural people is more, whereas the calorie needed for the urban people is less, because it is assumed that the people living into the rural areas, they used to work hard, they used to do physical work in comparison to the people living into the urban area, and that is why they need more food grains, they need more calories in order to render the physical work. So here let us see, the people unable to consume specified calories were deemed to be the poor or below the poverty line. So any person who are getting less than the recommended calories is known as below the poverty line, or they are known as the poor. The second method is monthly per capita expenditure. So certainly let us see, in order to get this much of calories, certainly certain income is needed, because income is equal to consumption expenditure also. So minimum income needed in order to get the minimum income needed to get this much of calories, it is recommended by the Planning Commission in our country. So let us see this monthly per capita expenditure. This translate calories into money. It means translated calories into the money, and money required to consume the requisite calories. So person income per month in rupees. It means per month income for a person in order to maintain this much daily calories. And here, on the basis of 2009 and 10 prices, on the 2011 and 12 prices, and 2014 prices, here this income is given into the rural areas, into the urban areas. So according to the prices of 2009 and 10, a person living into the rural area should get minimum 673 rupees per month, whereas the people living into the urban area should get minimum 860 rupees per month income to maintain this much calories. Whereas in the year 2011 and 12, 816 rupees needed for rural person, whereas 1000 rupees is needed for urban people person per month. Whereas in 2014, let us see, 972 rupees needed, whereas into the rural areas for a person, and 1407 rupees needed for a person living into the urban areas per month. So people who are not able to spend even such amount in a month are considered below the poverty line. So the person who are unable to spend 972 rupees in rural areas and 1407 rupees in urban areas, they are considered as below the poverty line. So according to the 2011 and 12 survey, we can say according to the 2011 and 12 data of the Planning Commission, about 22% of the population of our country were below the poverty line, or national poverty level was 22%. But there were certain states where the poverty line was far above the national poverty line. The national poverty line was 22%, but there were certain states where the people living below the poverty line was more than 22%. So let us see poverty levels in four states here. Odisha is there, 36% of the people were below the poverty line in the year 2011 and 12. In Madhya Pradesh, 36% of the people were below the poverty line. In Bihar, 34% people were below the poverty line. Uttar Pradesh, 30% of the people, they were below the poverty line. So national poverty line was 22%, but there were certain states where the number of people below the poverty line was more than the national poverty line average. So let us see what are the limitations of the poverty line. So there are certain limitations of the poverty line. The first limitation of the poverty line is this mechanism groups all the poor together and does not differentiate between the very poor and the other poor. So what happened? This poverty line, the poverty determined in our country, the poverty estimated in our country by the Niti Aayog or by the Planning Commission, this is based on the consumption of food and other commodities. It do not consider it do not differentiate between the poor and the very poor. Let us see, there are different categories of the poor in our country. There are chronic poor, there are transient poor, but it do not differentiate between the chronic poor and the transient poor. So certainly let us see, this mechanism groups all the poor together. It means all the poor are kept in one group only. It do not differentiate between the very poor and the other poor, because in the society there are certain people, they always remain poor. There are certain people, they occasionally become poor. There are certain people, they are usually poor. So this do not differentiate between the different groups of the poor. And the second limitation of this mechanism is that this mechanism takes into account expenditure on food and other commodities as the basis of estimating poor. Economists question its basis. So let us see, the estimation of poverty in our country is on the basis of the consumption of food and other commodity. It do not consider other factors which are related to the poverty, and that is why it is being criticized by some of the economists. And third limitation is that there are many factors other than income and asset which are associated with the poverty. For instance, the accessibility to basic education, healthcare, drinking water, and sanitation. So these factors, let us see, are very, very important part of our life. And these factors are being ignored by the estimation of the poverty in our country. So this is one of the limitation of this use of this method. And last limitation is given, the existing mechanism for determining the poverty line does not take into consideration social factors. So this estimation of poverty line does not consider certain social factors. And such social factors are illiteracy, ill health, lack of access to resources, discrimination, or lack of civil and political freedom. So these social factors are ignored in our country while the poverty line is estimated, while the number of poor are being estimated in our country. So this is the limitation of the poverty line. I think the concept of the determination of poverty line and the limitation of poverty line is clear to all of you. Okay, thank you.